May 15th, 2010. Jackson Miller. 19-year-old male Jackson Alexander Miller was last seen on May 15th, 2010 in San Francisco, California. Soon after his disappearance, Jackson's 2004 Honda Pilot was found in a parking lot by the Golden Gate Bridge. Inside were his wallet, iPod, and cell phone. But no Jackson. The car's location was a devastating clue, suggesting an open and shut case. Leading up to his disappearance, Jackson's mental health had been in a downward spiral. He suffered from anxiety, depression, and OCD, which according to his family left him debilitated and hopeless at their Cupertino home, an hour from San Francisco. For help, he had been taking medications, but his family was concerned over a recent prescription change and that he had stopped taking regular doses. The Golden Gate is a notorious destination for those looking to make the final decision and end their own lives. As the second most used suicide bridge in the world, it has had over 1,400 known jumpers since its construction in 1937. Bridge officials report an average of several hundred attempts a year, about one every other day. The last known images of Jackson come from parking lot surveillance cameras, which capture him arriving at 4:10 p.m. He exited the vehicle and crossed the parking lot towards a bus stop in the bridge's pedestrian tunnel. At that point, his image was lost. Additional surveillance cameras, specifically designed to monitor the bridge for suicide jumpers, could hold the answer in what appeared a tragically obvious outcome. To the relief of the Millers, the bridge had no footage of anyone jumping that day. Additionally, no bodies were recovered in the water. If Jackson did jump from the Golden Gate, why did he leave his car in that parking lot? Perhaps he had planned to commit suicide, but changed his mind when he arrived. A common occurrence with Golden Gate jumpers. Or he could have used the bridge's macabre reputation, in part by the Golden Gate on purpose, to suggest suicide, but in fact had other intentions. Jackson's family and friends immediately became involved and cast a net across the city, searching San Francisco's youth hostels and homeless shelters. Buoying the family's belief that he was out there alive were several reported sightings of Jackson that first week in the crowded Fisherman's Wharf area. Unfortunately, the sightings were never confirmed. Despite a thorough search of the city's shelters, Jackson was never found. With no leads and no crime, the case of the young man who walked away from it all by the Golden Gate went ice cold. 4 years later, in 2014, police in Lake Tahoe received a tip from a resident who claimed to have seen Jackson several times in the South Lake Tahoe area. Police noted that the caller seemed extremely confident they had seen the missing young man, but the sightings, once again, were never confirmed, and the trail went cold. Around that time, Jackson became part of the California Five, a name given to five young men who had all gone missing in San Francisco between 2010 and 2013. None of the men have been found. Theories exist that cases may be related, possibly the result of a serial predator or even a cult, but no official link between the disappearances or the young men has ever been established. Since the 2014 Tahoe sighting, new information on the whereabouts of Jackson Miller has gone silent, but his mother, Gina Fornaro, remains active in keeping the search for her son alive. She's encouraged by the reported sightings of Jackson and believes he has an unforgettable smile and laugh that anyone who met him would immediately recognize. Gina asks that if you see Jackson, to not let him out of your sight and to contact authorities immediately. Had Jackson been part of a larger conspiracy to abduct young men for use in ritual and occult blood sacrifices? Or had he become overwhelmed by his mental health issues and swept into a nameless and faceless sea of homeless people who wander our nation lost in time, imprisoned in their minds? If you have any information on the whereabouts of Jackson Alexander Miller, please call or text the Santa Clara County Sheriff's Department or NorCal Alliance for the Missing or 1-800-THE-LOST.